Listening Library presents A to Z Mysteries, The Deadly Dungeon by Ron Roy. Read by David Pittu.
The Deadly Dungeon. Chapter 1. Dink squirmed in his seat. He, Josh, and Ruth Rose had been riding the bus since 7 that morning. They were on their way to Maine to visit their friend Wallis Wallace, a famous mystery writer. The three of them had met her when she came to Green Lawn. Dink smiled when he remembered how they had rescued Wallace from a kidnapper. Dink glanced over at Josh, asleep in his seat. His sketch pad was open on his lap. Behind Josh, Ruth Rose was looking at a map. She liked to dress in one color. Today it was green, from her t-shirt to her high tops. Dink moved into the seat next to Ruth Rose. "Where are we?" he asked. "Almost there." She pointed to Belfast, Maine on her map. "We just passed a Welcome to Belfast sign." Dink nodded. That was where Wallace was picking them up. Ruth Rose tucked her map into her pack. "I'm so excited," she said. "Do you think her castle has a moat and a dungeon?" "I just hope it has food," Dink said. "I'm starving." Josh's head popped up in front of them. "Me too. Are we there yet?" Just then the bus driver called out, "Belfast." "All right," Josh said, leaping into the aisle. The bus stopped in front of a small, gray shingled building. Through the window, Dink could see the water. "Do you see Wallace?" Ruth Rose asked. Dink grabbed his pack. "No, but let's get off. I think I'm allergic to buses." The kids headed for the front. They followed an elderly couple down the steps. They were squinting into the blinding sunlight when they heard someone say, "Hi, kids." A tall man with curly blonde hair was walking toward them. His face was tanned and smiling. "I remember you. You're Wallace's brother," Ruth Rose said. "Call me Walker, okay?" said the man. "Wallace is buying groceries, so she asked me to get you." Walker Wallace picked up Dink's pack. It clunked heavily against his leg. "What's in here, your rock collection?" he asked. Dink grinned. "Books. My mom said it rains a lot in Maine, so I came prepared." Walker laughed. "We've planned perfect weather for you guys. Sun every day. Come on, that's my Jeep over there." Walker's dusty brown Jeep had no top. The leather seats were worn and split in places. He swept a pair of boots and a tool belt onto the floor, making room in the back seat. "Pile in." The boys climbed into the back. Ruth Rose sat next to Walker. "How far is the castle?" she asked. "Not far," Walker pointed. "About a mile past those trees." He drove up the coast. "You guys hungry? Sis is buying everything in the store for you." "I'm always hungry," Josh said, leaning back and crossing his legs. He took a deep breath of the ocean air. "What a smell." "I'll say," Dink said. "Get your smelly foot out of my face." "It's not smelly," Josh said, wiggling his sneaker under Dink's nose. "What's this?" Dink plucked a bright green feather off the sole of Josh's sneaker. Josh shrugged. "I must have picked it up on the bus." Dink slipped the feather into his pocket. "There's Moose Manor," Walker called. He pointed through the trees. Dink stared at the tall castle. It was built of huge gray stones. Its small dark windows looked like watching eyes. An iron fence surrounded the building. "Cool," Dink said softly. "Look, guys, a moat," Ruth Rose said. "And a drawbridge," cried Josh. Walker pulled up in front of the gate. The kids hopped out with their packs. "I have to get back to my boat," Walker said. "Sis should be here soon. Have fun." He waved and sped back through the trees. Up close, the castle towered over the kids. The battlements on top reminded Dink of giant's teeth. Josh pushed the gate and it creaked open. They peered down into the moat. Ruth Rose let out a laugh. "Look, guys." The bottom of the empty moat was planted with flowers. "Hey, guys," Josh called. "Check this out." He had crossed the drawbridge and was standing in front of an enormous wooden door. He tugged on the handle, but the door wouldn't budge. "How the heck does Wallace get in?" Just then, Dink heard a car. A red Volkswagen convertible zoomed up to the gate. The horn tooted, and a hand waved wildly. "It's Wallace," shouted Dink. Chapter 2. "Welcome," Wallace yelled. She looked the same as Dink remembered. Happy smile, curly brown hair, mischievous eyes. "What do you think of Moose Manor?" she asked. "Isn't it fun?" "I love it," said Ruth Rose. "It's awesome," Josh said. Wallace laughed. "It is something, isn't it? Help me with these groceries and I'll take you on the grand tour." The entrance to the castle turned out to be a regular-sized door around the corner. Wallace and the kids carried bags of groceries into a large room. Dink saw a washer and dryer, wooden pegs for hats and coats, and a pile of sneakers and boots. "This is my mud room," Wallace said. "The kitchen is through here." She shoved open another door with her hip. Dink had to tip his head back to see the high ceiling. The usual kitchen stuff was there, with a long wooden table in the middle. A black chandelier hung over the table. "This place is humongous," Dink said. "That's why I love it," Wallace said. "Let's put the food away and I'll show you around." The kids quickly emptied the bags while Wallace put the milk and ice cream into the refrigerator. "Okay, the tour begins in the royal living room," Wallace said. "Follow me." She led them into the biggest living room Dink had ever seen. The first thing Dink noticed was the chandelier hanging right over his head. It was as big as Wallace's car. A marble fireplace took up almost one whole wall. The mantle was dark wood, carved with all kinds of animals. "This place is amazing," Dink said. "Jeez," Josh breathed, peering into the fireplace. "You could burn a whole tree in here." Wallace flopped onto a pile of floor cushions. "Some winter days I wish I could," she said. "It gets mighty cold up on this cliff." "How old is this place?" Ruth Rose asked, peering up at the tall stone walls. "Pretty old," Wallace said. "It was built in the 1930s by a movie star named Emery Scott." "Awesome," Josh said. "What happened to him?" Dink asked. "Well," Wallace raised her eyebrows and lowered her voice, "according to the town gossip, he died suddenly, right here in the castle. In fact, sometimes I think I hear his ghost." The kids stared with open mouths. Then Dink laughed. "Come on, you're just kidding, right?" "Why? Don't you believe in ghosts?" Wallace asked with a grin. "No way," they all yelled. "Well," Wallace stood up, "maybe Emery will introduce himself when he's ready. In the meantime, why don't I show you your rooms?" The kids grabbed their packs and followed Wallace up a wide stone staircase to the second floor. At the top of the stairs was a dim hallway with several doors. Wallace pointed to one. "That's my room. Ruth Rose, yours is there, and I've put you boys together right across the hall." Wallace tapped on a narrow door at the end of the hall. "This one leads up to the roof." Dink opened the door to their bedroom. Like the rooms downstairs, the ceiling was high. A blue carpet covered the stone floor. The twin beds had bright red covers. Dink went to the window and looked outside. All he could see were pine trees. "Where's the ocean?" he asked. "On the other side," Wallace said. "Why don't you settle in, then come down for lunch?" Ruth Rose went to her room. Dink and Josh dumped their packs on their beds. "This place is so cool," Josh said, wandering into their bathroom. Dink stacked his books on the table next to his bed. He pawed through his clothes, then changed into shorts and a t-shirt. "Dink, come in here," Josh called. Dink wandered into the bathroom. "Listen," Josh said. He had his ear against one of the bathroom walls. "What are you doing?" asked Dink. Josh made a shushing sound. "I thought I heard something." "What's going on?" Ruth Rose said as she came into the room. "Josh thought he heard something behind the wall," Dink said. Ruth Rose grinned. "It must be the ghost of Emery Scott. He's just waiting for you two to fall asleep tonight." Just then they heard Wallace's voice. "Come and get it," she called. They raced down to the kitchen. Wallace was packing a basket. "It's such a great day. I thought we'd have a picnic on the beach," she said. "Cool," Josh said. Can we go fishing there sometime?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.